Welcome back to The Rhode Show. This morning in The Buzz, we are talking about the weekend box office and what the critics had to say. Mm-hmm. Now, a lot of people didn't expect big things from the Batman versus Superman movie, but it looks like a lot of people, they really liked it. The film raked in $170 million, and that was over Easter weekend, a holiday weekend. Other movies that did better than critics would have liked, My Big Fat Greek Wedding 2. So we wanted to know, do you care about what the critics say?
Not really.
It's crazy because, no, I really don't either. I gotta be honest with you, I really don't.
I'm a fan of sometimes like those stupid funny movies. And by that I mean, I know, if it's something with a Will Ferrell or when the first Anchorman came out, or, you know, I found that comical and I did want to see it, but I remember that one getting slammed, you know, reading the paper and seeing, hey, that was a movie that I liked and noticing it got one star. So sometimes I take them with a grain of salt, if it's something that I'm already interested in seeing.
Sure.
If it's a movie that I haven't really heard too much about, it depends, I guess.
I go by more what friends will say about the movie. I heard a couple of my friends, actually Ron St. Pierre, who's over at HJJ, he was posting something saying, forget what the critics said, the movie was great.
Yeah.
My other friend Matt Allen at WPRO, he was posting something, said he loved the movie. He loved Batman versus Superman. I love those superhero movies. I really do.
Well, that's
I love those movies.
Right. And that, again, if you already have interest in that, I think that will
that helps
you to
along
the theater. Well, plus now, I mean, it takes a lot for me to actually spend the money to go to the theater. So I feel like the movie has to be pretty great.
There are many times, actually, when a lot of new movies come out, we get invited like maybe couple of weeks before the movie comes out. And I've gone and I've sat some of these movies with some of these quote-unquote movie critics. And while I've enjoyed the movie, because I guess I'm not really a movie critic, as I'm walking out, I hear a lot of these guys and who write for newspapers or who are movie critics for different places across the country talking about the movies. And I'm like, just like, guys, they don't seem like they can even enjoy the movie.
Right.
Because they're so busy
nitpicking
and writing, trying to think up something snarky to write about a movie instead of writing it in there. And they're so into like the cinematic stuff and this wasn't shot well. It's like, guys, that's not what these movies are for. They're just for people to go and be able to enjoy these movies and have fun.
I know every Friday on my way in, I listen to Fun 107, who's right nearby too, and every Friday they do movie reviews.
Right.
So it's nice. It even just reminds me of what's out in theaters.
Yeah.
But yeah, like I said, there are some that I want to see, and they might get a poor review, but I'll probably go see it anyways.
And you know what? I've got to be honest with you. I wasn't really even that interested because some of the like the preview of the Batman versus Superman I didn't think was going to be that great, but even after hearing about how much money it made and that other people really liked it, it only makes me want to go see it more.
Yeah,
it really does.
It works on the opposite end too. Sometimes these best picture movies I have no interest in seeing.
I really don't.
You can hype it up all you want. I don't want to
too
see
artsy.
That. All right, let's head on over to Facebook to see what our friends are saying today. Josephine Slop does read reviews of new movies, and unfortunately, a bad review might influence her for a movie she knows nothing about. So maybe she won't see Batman versus Superman. Patricia Adelio Estrella also shares, saying, I think some critics are influenced by their own personal preference. I like to set my own opinion. LJC Artist says, sure, I read the reviews. Why waste my time on yet another Batman film? Let it go, people. So over it. A sequel equals not for me. Linda Shortman ends on a positive note. She says, I think it's good to find critics with tastes similar to you and follow their reviews. Fan favorites like superhero movies are often critic-proof because of the fan base. I'm happy to see how many people enjoyed Batman versus Superman this weekend. Very nice of you to say. Time now to check out what's trending in the New England Tech Center. Did you head to the movies this weekend and what did you see? Maybe you saw a big fat Greek family throw a wedding, or maybe you decided to watch those two superheroes battle one another. Did the reviews impact your decision? Well, some of you did listen to the critics and others watch what they want to watch. And have you ever wondered what the stars of the movies think when they hear the reviews? You know, particularly the bad ones? We're about to show you.
Just wondered whether that, how that makes you guys feel and whether it will even affect the film as such.
Well, the interesting thing is that we...
Hello, darkness, my old friend, that was planted in my brain, still remains within the sound of silence.
these partly have spoken.
Ben?
I agree.
Well, the music just makes the entire clip. And hey, Ben's doing just fine because in addition to that $170 million, Batman vs. Superman raked in over $424 million worldwide. So if you have a review of a movie you saw recently, share it with us. We love movies and are always up for suggestions or maybe ones to avoid. We can be found on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. All of those are at The Rhode Show.